Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, Artcast number 72, I think. Got to do one more fill-in show, just almost done with that commission I've been talking about, but thought I'd show you guys how to cut a piece of Masonite or hardboard. Sorry, I'm looking over at the screen because I can see it past my camera. So, for when you're doing your drawings, I've seen some people talking on the forum or the Artcasters Facebook group about, you know, needing a saw or something like that, and I just thought I'd show you a real quick tip that you can cut pretty much any kind of manufactured board. First off, I wanted to say though that when I change the settings, like if you watched my videos yesterday, I talked about changing the settings on the Facebook group so that only the administrators could let people in to kind of keep the spammers out, and when I did that, I think I actually kicked out a bunch of people. All the people that got let in by just random members, when I changed that setting, it booted all those people back out. So I'm sorry about that. I've been getting messages all morning and people wondering, like, how come I got banned? So if you got banned or got kicked out, you're not banned. Nobody's banned, actually. That's why. It was just a mistake on my part, and come, you know, rejoin. You guys are all welcome to come back in. And I don't know, some people like were concerned about like what am I talking about with the spam and stuff. I mean, I didn't mean to get everybody all worked up. I think it's just you know, like if you're posting eBay links are still welcome, but just post it with a photo or something of what you're doing. You know what I mean? Don't just throw your links up and then leave and not even interact, you know. If you want to post your Patreon links and stuff like that, same thing. You know, if you got a Patreon going or you got a Kickstarter or something like that, you're welcome to come in and talk about it. All the webcomics guys, everybody is welcome to talk about what they're doing. But just post stuff, you know what I mean? Don't just post your links and then leave with nothing. You know, that gets old because it just starts filling up the feed and then, you know, stops the conversation. Also, like, if you're going to post some of your work, you know, post a piece and write something about it, but don't post your entire portfolio. That always drives me crazy when somebody comes in and just like post 20 pieces in a row and nobody gives any comments, nobody gives any likes, because it's overwhelming. So, you know, the rules are, there's no rules, it's just common sense, you know. There you go. Anyway, everybody's welcome to that group. I don't, you know, it's like every morning I get up and there's more drama on Facebook, and this was the newest thing on with the drama on Facebook. So, you know, I don't know, it's supposed to be fun for everybody, and everybody's welcome, and, you know, it's still a great group. I love the interaction on there and all the tips, and it gives me ideas for videos, and it's easier to talk to everybody, you know, rather than just one-on-one with everyone. So, but anyway, I have a piece of scrap piece of Masonite. I don't need to actually cut a, hang on a sec, my lights are completely blown out. I'm going to adjust my camera. Okay, I'm back. So, like I said, I got this nice piece. I think this is 16th. It's a little bit bowed. It's just a scrap piece. So it's sitting over on my pile of stuff. But I can still use like one side of this for sure. Let's see how big this is. It's about 8.5. So if it's 8.5, I can make it an 8x11. I think I'm gonna make this an 8x14 though. Just cause I'm looking for a pencil. Just cause when I measure, this is a trick I learned over time, is like when I make my mark, I always make a mark on on the ruler, because it's so easy to stick something on there and go to the wrong number. Even though, like, I was, you know, in construction forever and did a lot of carpentry and stuff, I always had trouble with, you know, numbers and measuring and all that kind of stuff. So that's just a trick I use. Anyway, draw your line. Oh. get out your knife. This is, so people ask me about this all the time too. What do I use to sharpen my pencils up to a fine point? And this, I've showed this a few times, but I'll just re-show it because I know people don't watch every one of my videos. I mean, how could you? It's basically like a folding drywall knife. But that's what it is, or a utility knife is what they're called. And this one's awesome because it's like, you can pull the blade out the front like that. And what's awesome about these is then you can buy these packs of blades. Actually, let me grab a pack. So here's like a pack. I think there's like 100 in here. And let me show you. See, they just come out right there. Put that one back in because I don't need it. And then the whole thing, see, they're all lined up in there. They just slide out the top. You can get them at like Home Depot or hardware stores and stuff like that. But I mean, that's like $9, I think, is what I paid for that. And there's like 100 super sharp blades in there. And you can actually get carbon blades and stuff like that too, which are even more hard and will last longer. But what's nice about it is it's like you always have like a new, actually I'm going to flip that over because I want the new side, or maybe I'll just put a new one in. But you always have like a new blade in your knife, so you're not going to cut yourself trying to cut with a dull blade and stuff like that. And I mean, you could also use an X-Acto knife, but what I love about these is they're so hefty. You know, this is actually what I used to use when I cut into like drywall and stuff like that. That, you know, it's like you can really bear down on and stuff. And like X-Acto knives, they're so delicate. They're made more for like cutting frisket and that kind of thing. So this is just a super cheap alternative. And they're, you know, they're super easy to sharpen your pencils with. Once I got, you know, I used to always sharpen with the knife, but I used to have kind of a tough time keeping the knife sharp and things like that. But with this, it's like, you know, you always got a sharp blade and it's easy to sharpen your pencils with, and also do stuff like this. So anyway, I got my line draw, and of course it's a thick board, so I'm not going to be able to cut through this in one shot, or if I did, it would take quite a bit of work. I'm going to do this so that I have a massive ruler. I usually do this on the floor, so it's a little bit easier. Give it one swipe. Maybe two swipes. Not too hard. And I got my line kind of cut in. What I usually do is stick my blade in my line, roll it over. I'm not really cutting the ends. What I'm doing there is I'm making marks on the back side that I can see, which I know they're hard to see. And now I'm on the back side. Just throw my ruler across that. Give it a couple light scores, really. They're not even cuts. You can see I cut on both sides, basically scored on both sides. I didn't really even cut through. Thing's still solid, but if I just give it some pressure now, you know what I mean? And it's like a kind of a ragged edge, which just takes some sandpaper and smooth that out, and then there you go. Nice 8.5 by 14 inch board to draw a piece of movie art on. Like I said, this is MDF. Totally works on Masonite, though. MDF is pretty kind of lightweight stuff. Masonite has like a thing on it, you know, like a cooked surface or something. It can be kind of tough. But just, it's easy to cut if you do it that way, so. And then, like, I've been actually gessoing the backs, but you can gesso the front, of course. That's my gesso on the back of, what is this, Clint Eastwood, which needs to get shipped here. I've just been doing it because it gets it straight when you're painting on the front and you're putting all that wet medium down. keeps the board nice and flat because it's shrunk on the back and shrinks on the front, and you know. And of course you can, I like to draw paint on the raw board, but that's just me, that's part of my style. And it's just, you know, so I don't like to gesso. But you know, when you gesso the back, it just kind of keeps it more flat. But also I painted plenty of paintings with like no gesso or nothing. It's a nice surface to paint on the MDF. What else? That's pretty much it for this video. I just wanted to make a short one to get one up on Friday. This has been a tough week to get videos out because of that piece I'm working on, but it's almost done, and it will for sure be done over the weekend. So on Monday I'll be back to my old routine of drawing. Sorry about all the trouble at the Facebook group. It's like definitely didn't mean to do that. You know, it's hard. You know, like, I don't know. I'm sure there's somewhere that Facebook has wrote down like all the things, you know, about making a group. But you know, of course I haven't read it. So I just started this group. I didn't think it would get all big like it is. And you know, now it's almost to 200 members and stuff. And I don't know. I just want it to be like a place that, you know, that's everybody can go and, you know, is friendly and helpful and, you know, just, that's a lot of it, just friendly and helpful and is of value to everyone. So anyway, thanks for hanging out with me again, and I'll see you guys at the Artcasters chat on Sunday, which is the open chat, Google chat, that anybody's welcome to come and join in. Can only fit 10 people in there. I don't think we've ever hit 10 though, but what you've got to do though is you just got to go to the Artcast or the Google Hangout page for the, if you're in the Facebook group, Peter posts the Google Hangout at the top of the group. He pins it to the top, and then yeah, my son's taking a bath. That's what all that racket is. And the bathroom's right behind me. But that's how you get in there, and you just gotta click that you're gonna watch it, and then Peter will send you Peter Palmiotti is who I'm talking about. He sets up the hangouts for the weekend, so it's on Sunday. I don't know what time. It's usually either around noon or it's around 10 p.m. like Mountain Time. Just depends on who can come, who wants in. So, but yeah, catch that over the weekend if you haven't got enough videos, and I'll see you guys.